What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. In one of our previous videos, we introduced Regexes, and using these patterns, we were able to extract several matching char sequences in a given string. In this video, we will put everything we learned to the test by making use of these Regexes or patterns in Java. So, the Java Regex API consists of two core classes, the Pattern class and the Matcher class. The Pattern class provides no public constructors, hence to create a pattern we must first invoke its public state compile method, which will then return a pattern object. This method accepts a regular expression as its argument. In this example, we created a pattern by making use of the regex you see in front of you. Now, a matcher interprets the patterns and performs match operations against an input string. It also defines no public constructors. So, to obtain a matcher object, we have to invoke the matcher method on a pattern object. After obtaining a matcher object, a set of methods is unlocked for us. Let's break them down. The matches method returns a boolean and will match the whole given string to the whole pattern. So, either the whole string matches the pattern or not. In this example, the matches method will return true. The next method is the find method. This one will attempt to find the next expression that matches the pattern within the same input string by starting at the very first index of that string. So, in the example you see, we have three matches in our string corresponding to the current regex. Therefore, the find method will keep returning true every time we invoke it until the fourth time, which will be equal to false. This method is usually used while looping over the matching sequences of a given pattern in an input string. If we pass to the overloaded version of this method, let's say the value 5, then it will check if there is a match starting from index 5. So, here, because the match sequences are before index 5, then it will return false. However, if we pass to it, let's say 2, it will return true. Now, the next method, and the one I personally use the most, is the group method. This method will provide the group associated to the number passed to it. So, here we have three groups, and if a match is found in the string passed, group 1 will return to the very first group, group 2 the second, and so on. Additionally, if you provide 0 to the method as input or no arguments at all, the whole match with all of the groups will be returned, as you can see. The start and end methods should be straightforward now. One returns the starting index of a matched subsequence, and the latter returns the ending index of the matched subsequence or group. If no parameters are provided to these methods, start will return the index of the first character matched, and end will return the offset after the last character matched. So, here the outputs are as you can see in front of you. Moreover, group count will return the total number of the matched groups in the given input string. So, in the example we have, group count will return 3. The last couple methods I want to cover in this part are the replaceFirst and replaceAll methods. These methods will replace the text that matches a given regular expression. As their names indicate, replaceFirst replaces the first occurrence, and replaceAll replaces all occurrences. In this example, we replaced the first and all of the occurrences of the space character with the underscore character, respectively. Now, while going through the examples we gave, you may have noticed how we had to escape a few characters in the regex we wrote, also known as meta characters. You see, in regex, meta characters are characters with a special meaning. Like we previously saw, for example, the dot in regex is not actually a full stop, but it refers to any single character. So, if you really want to match these characters in their literal form and not their meta character meaning, you must escape the meta character you want to match. To escape a meta character, you have to precede it with two backslashes. In this example, the dot character is escaped by the backslash character. When escaped, the dot character will actually match a dot in the input text. Similarly, a backslash should be added when dealing with predefined character classes, such as the backslash s or backslash d, etc. So the backslash s will become double backslash s, and so on. Okay, since the beginning of the video, we've only created pattern objects in the most basic way. However, this class has another variant of the compile method that accepts a set of flags alongside the regex argument, and it affects the way this pattern is matched. Let's take a look at the most used supported flags and how they are used. First, the pattern.caseInsensitive flag. This flag enables matching regardless of case, as by default matching takes case into consideration, as you can see in this example. You can also use the equivalent embedded flag expression to achieve the same result. Java allows you to include comments using the hash sign in the regex. This can help in documenting complex regexes that may not be immediately obvious to another programmer. When pattern.comments flag is used, it lets the matcher ignore every text starting with the hash character from the entire regex input. There is also an alternative embedded flag expression for this. Next is the pattern.all flag. By default, when we use the .meta character in regex, we are matching every character in the input string until we encounter a new line character, as you can see. With this flag, the match will include line terminators as well. In these examples, without the flag, only the first part of the input before the line terminator is matched. However, when used, the entire text, including the line terminator, is matched. Now, when the pattern.literal mode is active, the matcher gives no special meaning to any meta character or regex syntax and will match the given expression literally against the given string, just like the example you see. Finally, the last flag we are going to discuss is the pattern.multiline flag. By default, the caret and the dollar sign meta characters match the beginning and the end of the entire input string respectively. However, when we use this flag, we will find matches within each line separately, since the matcher now takes into account line terminators. This flag has also an embedded version of it, and here it is. Now, just like we did in our previous regex video, and to make sure that you got everything we went through, I've put through the 8 patterns, matchers, and strings you see. What I need you to do is try to deduce the output of these code snippets. So if you want to go through this exercise, pause the video now. If not, the answers will appear in 5. And here you go. Hope you got everything right. So that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.